Hey, Kevin from JJ Hat Center. Today we're going to be talking about this new hat called the Hamilton. Look at that teardrop. It's a whiskey color. Great, great company, SELENTINO. SELENTINO is from the Czech Republic, who's got a huge history, an old history of making very, very elegant, well-designed hats. See that? Double bow, wind cord, very nice teardrop. It's a little more sculpted and sensual looking than like the Whippet or something, which is a little bit more blocky. It's got a little bit more curve and pizzazz to it. The band is wider and a little bit more vintage. Felt is nicer. And price is a little bit cheaper. Bound edge is thinner. It's just real classy. We used to do this hat a long time ago. We called it the Lexington. And, a long time ago. And, many, many years ago. 20 years ago or so. It was about $50 less, but it's good to see it back. Great hat. This hat will last you forever. Now, these guys predate Borsellino. They predate Stetson. Very old company. They're, I think, $17.99 or something like that. Yeah, $17.99. SELENTINO. SELENTINO is also called Tonac, is the company that sort of puts out SELENTINO. Tonac probably has other lines too. SELENTINO is known for their colors. They make colors, you know, like crazy, amazing colors, like, I don't know, just amazing things, orange and like, you know, great burgundies and yellows and royal blue and just amazing, all these colors. They also make great finishes. They do a velvety finish hat. We have a hat here called the Stamford, which we also got. And yeah, the Stamford is a, unfortunately, I think we're sold out of the burgundy. Yeah, the burgundy we're sold out of, but we have it in black. This one is a little wider brim with a velvety texture. It's got like a velour sort of a suede felt, so it's very velvety. You can see it there. Wind cord, single bow, very elegant. I'm going to show it to you in black because that's what we have. So this is a hat that a lot of people have been asking for. A hat with a center crease and no pinches. There you go. It's got a really classy velvety texture. Looks like a very thin bound edge. Very thin. Which is good. Gives it a little bit of strength. No pinches. So it's got that just a crease kind of Homburg thing. Right now they're selling so fast. The burgundy just blew right out. This I have size 7, 7 1/8, 7 1/4, 7 3/8, 7 1/2, 7 5/8. That's the biggest 5/8. They run a little bit full. It's a little bit fuller than Stetson, but they're pretty true to size, but a little full. Made in Czech Republic. This has a 4.5-inch crown in the front. Okay, 5 1/4 at the sides. Interesting. The brim is a 2.5. Binding is 3/16-inch. Ribbon is 1.5, so satin line, leather sweatbands, shipped with a box, okay, wind cord, velour finish, yeah, so yeah, it has no pinches, so you could do various things, you could do center crease, pinch front, you could teardrop it, you could whatever, pork pie it, or just leave it alone, will probably be the most elegant thing. But yeah, you can just trace it. You know, this is an elegant, elegant hat. It's like a black velvet, just super black, black. You know, the deepest, blackest, blackest. Think about Sly Stone's voice back in, like, you know, his heyday. Remember when he used to have that great baritone voice, like super deep? Like, you know, he should be doing some kind of midnight radio program. That's how black this hat is. Like, man, that guy had a great voice, didn't he? The dude was so handsome, too. I think of the blackest, darkest, blackest night when I think this is, it's like black velvet, but it's classier than velvet. It's fur felt. It's rabbit fur that's cut real short. So it's not like a thick velour, but it's a shorter velour. So it's like a very classy velvet texture. The Hamilton, let's go back to that. Hamilton is a more of a vintage looking hat. You know, for somebody who likes the Style Master and likes the Whippet, this is a better alternative, I think. It's got a little bit more authentic style on the teardrop. I like the particular shape of the bound edge. It's nice and thin. I like the way they do their ribbons. It has a certain, if you look at the bow itself has a kind of like the cross piece in the middle of the bow is like a square, which looks so, I don't know, it's authentic. It's got an authenticism to it. This is the whiskey color. Okay, let's talk about the whiskey color. It comes in, here's your whiskey, different views. Almost, yeah, it's beautiful, right? Is that a navy band or black? Let's see what they say about it. Okay, the Hamilton. 2.5 inch, hand sewn bound edge, wind cord, teardrop, Czech Republic, 100% fur felt. It's a 4 inch crown, 4.5 side, so it's lower. Naturally, it's a teardrop, you know, teardrop will be lower. Brim is 2.5, same size brim. So you got a teardrop and a center crease, no pinches. This one does not have the velvety finish. It's got a classic fur felt finish, like any other Whippet or whatever, you know. Style Master might be one of the more waterproof alternatives, but this hat will take it like a champ too. I believe in Celentino's felt, probably better than a lot of brands. They're really, really good, and you save some money. They're generally not expensive. They're just like high premium European made hats, and they're fair priced, you know. So, yeah, it looks like we do have the whiskey cognac color. We have it in black. We have it in navy blue. It's the navy blue teardrop. Oh, it's a good shot of the bands here. Okay. This might be my favorite hat band on any hat. I swear. I'm serious. See that little square in the middle? That's like a real 1940s, 30s band, you know? Look at that square. That is class. Yeah. The Hamilton has the best band. It's got the wind cord. It's an awesome, awesome hat. What's the last color? Navy with a thin band. Interesting. So that's nice, too. So we got a few pieces with a thin band, too, I guess. I don't know if that was on purpose or not. Maybe they just ran out of bands, so they just shipped a few that way. Companies do that. It happens, you know. Let me just make this a little clearer for you guys. Yeah, look at that bow. Hamilton. We used to call it the Lexington years ago. Comes with a little pheasant feather. They're such a classy company, Celentino. Even the feather they give you, the little shaft of the feather, the stick part, is wrapped with a wire so that it doesn't break and so you can stick it in, you know, look really hard and stuff. They're the only company who thinks of that. They give you a little wire around the feather. You got a guinea hen and a pheasant. You know, it's a classier feather. It's natural. It's not dyed feather. It's natural. You've got an elastic wind cord, which you can, you know, it's a real deal wind cord. You might want to reinforce it if you're going to actually use it, you know. You do that for any wind cord, though. That thin bound edge, the teardrop, which is just a little more graceful than other companies that making teardrops. It's very unusual to see a European company making a teardrop pad. It's just, you know, there's not a lot of them. You know, we have the Cyrus, which is one. There's this. Generally, European companies will do center crease, and what you have to do is teardrop it yourself. It's just a thing. Yeah, you've seen these labels. They have used the same linings and sweatbands, all those graphics and everything. Same ones, even in the vintage hats. When you find vintage hats, you know, from the 20s or something from Celentino, they look just like this. They're a really cool brand, Celentino. 100% fur felt. Very good hat for you, Marcus. I would have wished that we ordered some of the funkier colors, because I know the funky stuff sells. You know, like if we ordered this in whatever, royal blue, green, orange, and white or something, but you know, we stuck to a little bit more conservative colors. And not conservative, classical colors. And this, you know, so this is the wild one, which I like a lot. Not exactly wild, but classical. You got a brim up shot here? Here you go. Brim up shot. This is a hat. I guess if I was at work now, this would be the one I would take home. Generally don't do teardrops, but I miss this hat. I might have grabbed the other one in the burgundy, maybe. But I got a burgundy Bordeaux color in the Fulton not that long ago. That was my last year's hat. So I probably would have gotten this. Yeah, great hat. The Hamilton. So yeah, Selentino is an older brand from 1799. I think Borsellino's 1857, Stetson after that. So they're pretty much the oldest hat company around. Might be older ones, you know. I don't know some of those British ones, how old they are. But you know, we don't really deal with the British companies. They can be a little bit expensive. And they do a lot of cheaper lines that are just like, you know, just their name, but not even made in England. So it's good if you're going on vacation. You want to go to, you know, Locke or what's his name? Herbert Johnson or Locke and Company are the two big ones out there. The Hamilton, it's the vintage hat of the year. Oh, that Hamilton, it's the vintage hat with the flair. On the Mike Douglas show, talking deep, deep baby, deep black, and velvety, smooth. George Clinton's voice, think of smooth. Marvin Gaye, smoothie, smooth, 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 smooth. King of cheese, right? 13th chord at the end, you gotta hit that. Yeah, they're two really nice hats, and one of my biggest customers, Jason, who's just, he's one of these guys who buys everything good that comes out. Whenever something really cool comes out, he's like, text me, hello, how are you, Kev? Hey, how are you, Jason? What do you think of the Hamilton and the so-and-so, you know, and the Stanford? I'll tell him what I think, you know, I think it's good for him, the size, and then he gets it. He's probably, I don't know if he's our best customer, but he's one of those guys that loves hats. And, you know, he's got a huge collection. He can't even, like, you know, keep them in the house. They're so big. I was just talking to him, and he mentioned those hats. So you know, I found out about them and decided to do a show on them. We have now four hats from the Czech Republic, those two, and there's two more from Kappas Headwear. Kappas get them from Salentino. So there's a couple others, the Mercer and the Tribeca. The Mercer is the real short brim. It's a little smaller than 2 inch. It's like a 1 7/8 inch classic Sinatra crown, you know, pinch front, a little bit tall. Looks really cool. It's very authentic. It's like an old time hat, you know, just like a Saxon by Stetson, but a little more old timey or something. That's black and gray. And then there's the Tribeca, which is, you know, a little bit wider hat. It's very interesting. And it's very similar to the Stanford, kind of like a velvety, you know, wider hat and stuff. But it's wider, like 2 3/4 maybe. Forgot the brim width. So we have four hats now. Two of them, the Tribeca and the Mercer, which are branded as Kappas Headwear. Kappas is a New York brand that we get a lot of different straws from, a lot of caps from them. They're known for making classical stuff. We get our Boders. They import Boders from Italy, the Boder straw hats. They're all classic. You know, the Newsboys that are a little wider, the Big Apples, those come from Kappas. They're a New York old school brand. Right here in Queens is where they make the stuff. And they specialize in, you know, not expensive stuff, a little bit medium to lower, you know, made in USA stuff that's not expensive, you know, 100-ish or whatever. And straw hats, coconut straws, you know, they're not very expensive. A little bit cheaper Panamas in that like 100 to 200 range. But occasionally they do something a little bit better. And what they do is, instead of manufacturing it, they import it from somebody else. They go to Selentino, Tonek, in Czech Republic, and they order a couple of hats with their linings, with their names on the, you know, what do you call it, on the leather sweatbands. So it's branded as Kappas, a New York staple brand. Kappas Headwear is a good company. But they're actually made in the Czech Republic by, you know, Tonek, who makes their own line, Selentino, too. Just so you know the lineage of all this stuff. They're basically made by the same people. It's a very old, classic company. Their hat blocks are old, and they have been making the same hats, the same shapes forever, you know, like since the 70s, and then, you know, even before then, you know. There were different things, but they don't update their styles, all that. That's what's cool about them. But they have a big, big selection of felt textures and colors. And you could do it all, you know, kind of custom. So, you know, let's say a hat like the teardrop one I showed you before, the Hamilton, that could come in 35 colors. And you might be able to get it in some other textures, like a beaver or a silk beaver or velour. It's possible. I don't think so. I don't think you could change the texture. That I'm pretty sure you can't do. So it comes in a lot of colors. Then they'll have a few beaver numbers, long hair, you know, like a center crease, a wide brim, a short brim, you know. And so it's like a semi-custom, and it's just endless colors. And they make the colors that nobody else makes. And it's fantastic brands. They're super consistent. You're not going to find any loose threads on them. There's no quality control issues. There's no curling of the felt when it gets wet. It's one of those super grade felts, like, I'm going to say kind of like a Kubra. They're not as rugged as a Kubra. They're more of a luxurious, authentic dress hat, but they can take it. You'll have the hat for a very, very long time. So yeah, these are, I'm pretty excited. Generally, when we can't get Stetsons or our main brand that's dominating the shop at the time, we supplement with other brands. We can get a Kubra's quickly because they're very nice at shipping. They just ship it right out and it just comes. We can get Selentinos and Kappas at the drop of a hat, no pun intended. But certain other brands, they ship when they ship. And we order them well in advance, a half a year in advance. And they never come on time. They basically dribble in all through the year when they're ready. And so sometimes it's good to take advantage of some of these other brands because you get way more bang for the buck sometimes. And sometimes even more authentic styling or choices of colors, you know, like the Ontario. That's a brand that does unusual colors, light blue, royal blue, neon red,
pink rose. And Selentino is a brand like that too, like a cognac. You generally can't get lots of cognac or whiskey colors from, you know, a lot of American brands and stuff. But just wanted to say these are nice hats. And as Kevin from JJ Hat Center, I totally stand behind them. All of the Czech stuff, it's good. And if you're a amateur hat maker out there, the Czech bodies, the Czech felt is really good too. You might find that at some of your hat supply places. You guys know it's like about the best stuff you can get here is the Czech felt. So if you want some beaver or, you know, like shiny beaver, peluche or velour or something really nice and exotic, it's generally going to be made in the Czech Republic. They have a long, long history of making felt, good felt, and making dress hats and stuff. I suggest them. I think you'll be very happy with anything from Selentino. They are a different brand, so they might run slightly bigger, a little bit. Not hugely big, but they run a little bit bigger, I think. Yeah. When you order them, you can ask. Practicing that riff. Got the strap so low. Keep it up like the Beatles. Down a little, be kind of cool like this when you can't see it.